Doctor, can I bend forward? Can I pick up something from the ground? Can I carry a laptop bag? Can I go up and down the stairs? Can I go shopping? Can I go for a dance class? Actually, pregnancy is a very sensitive topic with most of women and their families. And there's a common belief thinking that any physical activity may actually harm the baby or may actually trigger premature labor or even an abortion. But fortunately, by design of nature, pregnancy is very, very strong, very robust. In fact, nowadays we have scientific research saying being physically active, doing exercises in pregnancy has immense benefits. So hello everyone, this is Dr. Anjali Kumar, once again bringing you greetings from Maitri. Maitri is a space where we talk anything and everything about women's health. So continuing with our pregnancy series, today we'll be talking about what all exercises you can do in pregnancy. So today I'm happy to welcome Rashmi Bawa. Rashmi Bawa is a certified childbirth educator. She is the director of Well Mom Antenatal. That's the company which has been working in the field of childbirth education for the last 2 decades. So I'm very, very happy to welcome Rashmi. Welcome to Maitri.
Hello, ma'am. Maitri is such a great initiative. Thank you so much.
Yes. So today Rashmi is going to be teaching you the exercises to be done in pregnancy. But before that, Rashmi, would you like to tell my viewers why should a pregnant woman exercise?
Yeah, of course. First and foremost, it keeps stress at bay. You are happy. So the anxiety is also taken care of. You feel more energetic. While you are exercising, small problems of pregnancies like backache, lower limb swellings, all these are taken care of. And the sleep, of course, is better.
The nausea becomes better. The vomiting is better. You have less of constipation. Women who exercise in pregnancy will have a better posture. You do not gain excessive weight. And of course, exercise helps you to build up the endurance, strength, good stretchability in your muscles so that the delivery becomes easier.
Yeah, but there are certain conditions wherein one should have caution and consult the doctor before you go ahead with exercising.
Absolutely true. So in case you've been having bleeding in pregnancy, in case you have incompetent cervix or you have a cervical stitch placed there, or if you have multiple pregnancies like twin, or in case you have low lying placenta, or your water bag is ruptured, or in case you have any infection. So these are the situations where you should definitely talk to your doctor, and even otherwise before starting the exercise program, please talk to your doctor before starting. But before that, few rules of the game. It is recommended that a pregnant woman must exercise for 30 minutes a day. But if you do not have that much of time, also any amount is good enough to start.
Yeah. And the mantra of exercises during pregnancy is that always listen to your body. Exercise has to be a pleasurable event. It should not be a punishing event. You should not feel breathless. And also, the thumb rule is that you should be able to talk while you're exercising.
Good. And obviously, you should be wearing comfortable clothes. You should hydrate yourself. Make sure that you finish your big meal at least an hour before you started the exercise. Most important, always exercise under the guidance of a proper trainer. So other than these specific exercises, which Rashmi is going to be teaching you, there are lots of other things which you should do over and above. You should be walking. Remember, walking is a low impact, but a very powerful exercise. If you are a good swimmer, you should swim.
Swim, Pilates, of course, yoga.
Yes. And if you're fond of dancing, why not?
Oh, wow. That is so great.
So over to Rashmi.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dolly, for joining us in this video. Now we are just going to demonstrate some exercises. Having a good posture is half the battle won. You can take care of any kind of cervical aches or backaches in the initial part of pregnancy with just having a good posture. A very simple exercise for that. Dolly, can you please step back here? Standing against the wall. Try to keep your head, the posterior part of the shoulders, the buttocks and the heels as close to the wall as is possible. Just be in this position for about 4 to 5 minutes in the morning, afternoon, night. And then whenever you're walking, try to just take your wall with you. Come Dolly, let's take the wall with us. That's a wonderful posture to attain. Now we are going to demonstrate the exercises to be done in the first trimester. Please note that these can be continued throughout your pregnancy also. Starting off with the cervical group of exercises, just take your head back, stretch and hold at the end range. Come back to the neutral position. Now just face towards the right hand side. Come to the end range, hold, back to the neutral position, onto your left now. Hold the position there and then very comfortably come back to the neutral position. For the second exercise, you just have to shrug your shoulders up, shrug up, hold, and very gradually take them down. Take care that the release is very, very important when we are talking about pregnancy exercises. There should be no jerky release from the postures there. Another wonderful exercise targeting the upper back muscles and of course supporting the breast muscles is a retraction exercise wherein you just have to bend your elbows with your palms facing upwards and take your elbows back. Reach the end range, hold it there and then very gradually take it back. We generally recommend doing 10 repetitions of each exercise in one set and at least having 3 sets in a day. Now we'll be starting from the breast exercises. A very simple exercise would be take one hand up, bend this particular elbow and try and touch the other shoulder. Hold it there and then very gradually just bring your hand back. Likewise, you need to do it with the other arm also, taking it up, bending, touching the shoulder and coming back. Another very simple exercise to help you with the breast musculature would be taking a hand up, folding it again, touching the spine, taking the other hand up, touching this particular elbow and pressing it vertically downwards. Hold and then just release this particular posture. Next is the wall exercise, which is a wonderful way to exercise the pectoral muscles. Fine. For this, you need to stand at an arm's length from the wall and just press forward. Please take care that the knees should be straight when you're doing this and then just come backwards. Repeat it again and come back to the neutral position. Pelvic tilt helps to relieve backache along with strengthening your back. For this, you need to stand with your back against the wall fully supported and then just try to shift the pelvis forwards so as to touch the wall with the back area. Try pressing backwards. Come back to the neutral position. Do it again. There is a very slight movement to the pelvic area, but it's a wonderful exercise to be done. This is the famous cat and camel or the hand and knees position. This position is very beneficial to help you combat backache during pregnancy. For this, the first thing that you need to do is you just have to rock forward and backward. A very slow rhythmical rocking should be done. Once you are very confident about this position, you can start the cat stretch. For the cat stretch, just look up and extend your back like a cat would do. And alternate this with the camel position wherein you need to make a hump like a camel. It would help if you could just try and look at your belly button when you are doing this. Again, come back to the cat position and the camel position again. Performing slow rhythmical movement of the lower limb is really important to help you fight off any kind of swelling, weakness or pain in the lower limbs. For this, whenever you come to the standing position from any resting position, just stand with your feet at least hip width apart with support initially. Just try to propel up on your toes and then go down. And once you are very confident, you can always use your hands for balance like this. Always try to incorporate weight shifts if you are standing for a longer time. It is as simple as just separating out your feet, taking all your weight onto one foot and then shifting out to the other foot. This is again a very good way to relieve any kind of pressure onto the lower limbs. The pelvic floor exercise or the Kegel exercise forms an integral part of any good antenatal exercise regime. This particular exercise tones up the pelvic floor and a very important exercise for us. For this, just envision that you are passing out urine and try to stop the flow of urine midway. Try to bring the vaginal musculature upwards. Take care that you should not be holding your breath when you are doing this. You should be humming a song or just speaking to anybody initially so that you can just target the specific muscles and release. Again, try to take the vaginal musculation upwards, hold on and release. A very simple exercise, but a very important one. In order to increase the flexibility and endurance of the body, along with the exercises in the first trimester, we add on certain exercises in the second and the third trimester. The first in these would be the wall sit-ups. For this, just stand again against the wall and remember to put all your weight onto the wall and then just bend your knees as if you are sitting down. Remember again, your weight should be onto the wall and not onto the feet. And then again, come up. It is a supported sit-up. In the later trimesters, it is a very good idea to increase the frequency and the time span of the exercises we have already done, along with adding specific exercises to increase the flexibility. For this, what you need to do is, we'll be doing the full squats now. Initially, when you support it, just try to stand straight with your toes pointing outwards and then just go down on your knees like this. The release is again very important in this. If you have a support, good. Otherwise, always keep a hand in front of you and then just propel yourself up to the standing position. Let's do the leg sways now. Leg sways are very important to help us with the flexibility of the body. For that, just keep one hand onto the wall and then sway your leg forward and backward. It should be a free flow. For the second type of exercise, what we need to do is, we just have to again take support of the wall, bring the foot forward and sway sidewards. Let us perform the forward lunge now. For this, you should hold on to any good support, take one leg forward, bend the knee so that the knee does not exceed the toes, take the posterior leg backwards and just sway forward and backward. Forward and backward, forward and backward again. In the final trimester, rocking in the butterfly position also helps to increase the flexibility. It is as simple as going on to one side and then coming on to the other side like this, a simple harmonic pendulum movement. In the third trimester, the focus shifts to increasing the joint flexibility and opening up of the pelvis. For this, sitting in the soles together or the famous butterfly position is a very good idea. Also remember that the age-old Indian practices of mopping the floor, using the Indian toilet and sitting cross-legged is also very good to have a normal vaginal delivery. When you're sitting like this, your back has to be straight. That is the very first precaution that you need to take. And gradually, you need to take your heels towards the perineum. Thoda sa apni taraf pull back karo. Again, the exercise should be comfortable. Gradually, you can increase the movement. For the grade 2 of this particular exercise, it is a good idea to again keep your hands onto the knees and press them down at least twice daily. So stay happy, stay very active, and health wishing you a very happy, healthy pregnancy.
So I hope this video motivates you to be more active in pregnancy, to follow a more active lifestyle in pregnancy. Actually, being active in pregnancy should actually be a norm, unless and until specifically instructed by a doctor not to exercise. Later, we will be also coming with a separate video on yoga in pregnancy. So please stay tuned. And once again, if you like the information today, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe to Maitri. And I will see you soon.